Whenever possible, attack should be made with the wind. But in some cases, to get proper distribution, it may be necessary to work crews against the wind. Poor timing or poor distribution may leave hot spots in the fire area. These are usually evidenced by dark streaks in the steam cloud. This is the officer's clue that a change in the pattern or direction of a stream may be necessary. With adequate flow and ideal distribution, knockdown should require only 20 or 30 seconds. Where distribution is not ideal, knockdown may take somewhat longer. In any case, when the fire has been blacked out, all lines should be shut down to avoid condensing valuable steam. Following knockdown, nozzles should be opened only for specific purposes, such as knocking down spot fires or overhauling. A steady state fire usually has sufficient airflow openings to ventilate the area during overhaul. Where additional ventilation is needed, it should be ordered only at a rate which will allow immediate follow-up by the overhaul crews. During overhaul, close coordination of nozzle crews is necessary. Each crew should have a specific objective. Poor timing or improper nozzle handling by one crew may prevent another crew from reaching their objective. Before attack, this fire had assumed a steady state. In a steady state fire, openings are available for air to flow into the fire and for the products of combustion to flow away from the fire. Oxygen in the air mixes with fuel vapors. In the combustion process, the fuel vapors and oxygen are united. This combining process gives off heat and forms new compounds. With ordinary fuel and sufficient oxygen, these products of combustion are mainly H2O and CO2. No matter how much fuel or fuel vapor is available to the fire, heat production will remain in a one-to-one relationship with oxygen supply or airflow. If the airflow coming into or away from the fire is reduced, heat production will be proportionately reduced. Ventilation of a structure fire seldom provides sufficient oxygen for complete combustion and maximum heat release. This is evidenced by varying amounts of dark smoke in structure fires. Where there are no openings for airflow, combustion will be limited by the oxygen supply. Heat production may still be sufficient to raise ceiling temperatures to around 1400 degrees before it is exhausted. When the oxygen supply is below that necessary for active combustion, the fire assumes a smoldering stage. If it were possible for oxygen to be suddenly distributed throughout the entire area, an explosion would take place. However, limited supplies of oxygen in localized areas may accelerate burning, but not cause an explosion. This type of fire has often been referred to as a third stage fire or a potential backdraft situation. With heat production limited, a smaller rate of flow can be applied into the heated overhead until temperatures are reduced to a safe level. Rate of flow in this situation is not as critical as with the steady state fire. In the steady state fire, we have a fresh airflow for continuing heat production. Here the rate of flow must be sufficient to overcome both accumulated heat and heat production. The nature of multi-story buildings presents an opportunity for erratic and unusual fire behavior and introduces additional problems for attack crews. There are many more avenues by which the fire may travel into remote areas which are not readily accessible to nozzle crews. Remote areas such as attics and false ceilings. Heat and products of combustion may flow into these remote areas. The temperature in these areas may be raised to the ignition point by the products of combustion from the fire below. the oxygen supply is so limited that it will not support flame production. In other words, while we have a steady state in our original fire area, we may have a smoldering stage in the remote areas. The attacking crew should be particular about their rate of flow and shutdown time in order to provide maximum steam for remote areas. If the flows are excessive or continued for too long a time, steam will be condensed and supplies of fresh air will be immediately available to highly heated remote areas. If the opening into the remote area through which the original fire has spread is of sufficient size, the in-fresh air may be rapid enough to cause a backdraft situation. Many firemen have witnessed this blossoming of fires on upper levels shortly after they have attacked a fire at lower levels. An additional problem in this type of situation is access points for the attack crews. It is very difficult to properly manipulate an attack line from a ladder, and attack lines improperly used from an outside position may push the fire into uninvolved areas or otherwise compound the problem. When structural conditions permit, the best approach to a one-room situation of this type is up an interior stairway. Whenever a crew is sent in to make this type of attack, they should always be backed up with standby lines inside and outside. Even though the officer may be almost certain his initial attack will be successful, he should plan for his alternate course of action. He should lay in lines and place backup crews in position outside as well as inside. Large volumes of steam are evidence that the nozzle man has done his job. The holding action of the steam allows the officer additional time to get overhaul crews into remote areas and coordinate their efforts. Coordination of the actual attack was not difficult in this case because only one attack crew was needed. In a more complex situation, the difficulty of coordination increases. Radio communication can be an invaluable aid in making a coordinated fire attack.
Chief to dispatcher.
Dispatcher, go ahead.
We got a worker here. Looks like it's in the main assembly they've been remodeling. Dispatch code 3.
10-4.
Chief to Captain Holly.
Captain Holly here.
Check to see if the carpenters are out.
10-4.
Chief to number 2.
This is Lieutenant Petrie with number 2.
Lay into south side and set up deluge gun to cover stairway between east and west sections.
Lieutenant Petrie, 10-4.